the words Brooke Harris was waiting for. Now to share the news with her father-in-law.
What did they say?
Yes. Really?
Good.
We're a match.
Joe Harris had been on a kidney transplant waiting list since 2016. Worried about his age and ability to care for his wife, he was eager to find a match.
I just was afraid that things were going to run out, and I would get to a point that I could only be on dialysis, and then I wouldn't be able to take care of her.
Multiple setbacks in finding a kidney donor deeply affected Brooke.
As soon as we found out and they told us that that second person didn't work, it was just this deep knowing in me that I need to test and find out. I didn't know why. I didn't have any reasoning or rationing for it other than I just need to see if I can do this.
And that test was a match. Dr. Michelle Wynn, a Mayo Clinic transplant surgeon, explains how direct donation works.
If you have a friend or a loved one who wants to donate a kidney to you, you match them by blood type and by tissue typing, you can donate your kidney directly to your friend or your loved one.
Not only would Joe get the organ he had been hoping for, but he'd also be the first patient at Mayo Clinic in Arizona to undergo robotic kidney transplantation.
Administrated bipolar in 4.
And I went, good. Let's do it. So I had no hesitancy about the robotic thing. The more I learned about it, the more I thought, this is going to be kind of cool.
In patients who meet criteria to receive robotic kidney transplant, the goal is that it will provide improved outcomes for the patient. Smaller incisions, less pain, faster recovery, faster return to work, or faster return to their day-to-day life.
Robotic kidney surgery doesn't replace the surgeon. Instead, it gives surgeons advanced tools to operate, as Dr. Nitin Kataria, a Mayo Clinic transplant surgeon, explains.
It is a console that has 4 arms, a separate sort of a console where you sit at, apart from the patient, where you can control the arms. And these arms articulate in ways you can control the camera, and you have multiple different instruments that you can switch out to navigate the anatomy and perform your operation.
For Brooke, she says the experience was easier than she thought.
A lot easier than I had anticipated, honestly. Even going back to the surgery, I have to say it's definitely not as scary as it seems. And then recovery was a lot easier than I had anticipated.
And for Joe, his gratitude for his daughter-in-law's selfless donation is hard to put into words.
How do you thank somebody for that? I don't know. It's so humbling. That's been hard for me in a way, but I'm grateful. And she knows how I care about her.
For the Mayo Clinic News Network, I'm Jason Howland.